Hi, I'm the flight chef. This is the worst intro ever.
Yeah,
and that's Aunt Lisa. Say hi.
Hi, I'm Aunt Lisa.
I'm supposed to say
what?
I'm supposed to tell you to say hi. Okay, actually, you probably were better off actually saying hi. But this is Pikmin 2, I guess. Yeah. So, she's probably gonna ask a lot of questions. And I just, remember guys, it takes years of experience to learn how to properly commentate. And I just randomly winged it, which means that's excuses! And I also told her just to talk. Because, I mean, she's not playing, but which makes it a lot easier for her, but still probably not. Oh, I have to read. Well. Okay, so I will just look back at this footage and see which ones are new and talk about those next time. Oh yeah, and the treasures too. Alrighty then, so you've collected the Fridges series. Chase away Winter Doldrum with this effect, with this festive set. Alright, that's a lot of new things, and that's the new things that has sales pitches. I believe I already did all those sales pitches, so. Going to area selection. To the Valley of Repose. Because apparently I missed a bunch of stuff. You're not talking.
Sorry.
Talk.
So, what's the difference between Pikmin 2 and Pikmin 3?
A very big one. First off, there's only two captains. Second off, this one you might not notice as much. Mm-hmm. You can't, like, order them to go places.
Oh, they're always together?
Well, no. You can do this, but you have to, like, first off, you can't throw them.
Oh.
And second off, you can't, like, they just sit there when you're not using them.
Oh.
So you can leave them to watch groups, I guess, but you have to, like, disband all your Pikmin to get rid of them.
Uh-huh.
Also, I can switch between them, even if they're in the same party. That sounds like they're fighting. I mean, it's better. Never mind. So, what I'm gonna be doing today is, so, another big difference, there's no actual day limit. And possibly the biggest difference is, you remember how to charge in Pikmin 3, right?
Yes.
You walk on, and you, as you can see, I have still slacked off and have not, I have yet to get all the whites and purple that I'm supposed to be trying to get. But, alright, so where was that? Oh yeah, so, that is not in this. You don't, like, charge them, you swarm them, which means by holding the down stick,
mm-hmm.
Wait, basically, look. Holding the down stick, don't do that. Sometimes they disobey, like, oh yeah, so Pikmin 1, they're like, they sometimes completely ignore you and stuff, like, so to show that they're not, like, trusting. So basically, see, they follow where the arrow is when I hold down on the remote control.
Okay.
And watch this. This happens, and I don't have to waste all of my Pikmin. I can just run through and keep going.
That's good.
Oh, wait, no, not Matites. And these are Matites.
What are those?
They're creatures in eggs. They are annoying. They do drop a lot of nectar, but basically what they are is they make Pikmin go all crazy so you can't properly attack. They can't hurt your Pikmin, but the thing about why they're in eggs, though, like, those are not, like, eggs. thing is, according to the Pikmopedia, which has enemy bios, bios on all 81 enemies. Oh wait, spoiler alert, there's 81 enemies! Yeah, I don't care. So, according to the bio, the female that scent is what makes the Pikmin go all wild. But to females of certain species, it smells great. It smells great, inspiring them to swallow the Matite female whole, in which the Matite female then inside the other female's body, then goes around and lays her eggs inside that female's eggs.
Wow.
I mean, yeah, and this is rated E for everyone. No, seriously.
Yeah.
And there's a lot. And as you can see, we are literally carrying back the corpses of our enemies to grind to make more for our ruthless army. Friendly E-rated action. Yeah. It's not very E-rated. I went over an episode like with this, and like there's a, but like I'm not like saying just that. Like there is a treasure called the Arboreal Fibbery.
Uh huh.
It's a green leaf with 5 pointed spikes.
Oh.
It looks sort of like an oak leaf, but green.
Uh-huh.
Are you wondering what the significance of that is?
Yes, I am.
You don't know why that's not good.
Yes, what's the significance of it?
Whatever, guys. This is a family show, so... this episode, I'm just gonna be getting the treasures you missed. You really don't need to watch this. Yeah, yeah, good, good. Because, just wanted to warn you, just so your life's not scarred. If you're children, I think someone died. Yay. I think I already scarred life, yeah. So, but, basically, where am I missing? You know what? They're just gonna die. Alright, so, you know how, you know what a green leaf, and it's in a very common place. You know what a green leaf is?
I know what a green leaf is, yes.
A green leaf and, well, hard to explain. I'll show you after the end of this episode. And then you'll see why this is a bad thing. I'll show it on camera, too. Oh, come on! I got both of them, which means I can't, like, throw Pikmin with the other captain. Alright, we already got all the treasure in here. Sorry, it seems I left some treasure. Oh.
Alright, what's that guy doing?
He's carrying the captains and throwing them on the ground to injure them. And I can't reach him. I don't like fumbling stitch bugs. That is a new type of enemy. Like, I'm pretty sure that, like, all types of... Yeah, if I remember correctly, all types of snitch bugs can do that in the Pikmin 3. Mm-hmm. Like, they can carry you, but... They don't want, like... they're not as persistent. They also carry Pikmin.
Okay.
And you can free yourself without having to have another captain. Because I went through, like... Yeah, I think I went through, like, one of these caves with a bunch of them.
Mm-hmm.
With one captain. And I was 2 throws to the ground away from death. So I had to restart and restart and restart.
Wow.
So, yes. That's basically the point. Basically, I missed a bunch of treasures because I was lazy here. These are caves. Basically, they're like dungeons. You have unlimited time here. Apparently, it's because the magnification is high.
Okay.
Alright, you know what? Since I'm down here, I do not need more reds. I think... Alright, so this By the way, I will show on camera how you get a ton of... I'm fucking things with the when I have the fuckaphone. Smart thinking. Oh, so look. I'm gonna show you something really pretty. Isn't it pretty? That is basically why you don't need red Pikmin. Red Pikmin are immune to fire.
Oh.
That was the time when we noticed how much, how easy it was for me to take control over that situation. Oh. Pikmin 1, you have like literally at most 2 seconds to take out the fire, but you have at least a minute to take out the fire in this game, so it's really not a threat unless like they're really far away and you're also getting attacked by a BD long legs or something like that. You know, because that's gonna happen. Alright, so... Red, I'm sorry to say. I know I'm kidding, I'm not sorry at all. Reds, you are complete. So yes, this is how you do it, you just... So yes, this is what how you do it. I mean, normally you would just rush down to the bottom floor if you're just doing the purples.
Yeah.
But I'm not doing just the purples. Like, I've seen like 2 playthroughs and they've always just rushed to the bottom and only gotten the purples. And then like on one of them, like playthroughs I saw on YouTube, and then one of them later on he didn't have like enough whites.
Oh.
See, whites and purples in this game, like you've only seen them in mission mode where there's a limited amount.
Right.
But whites and purples can only be obtained by trading out other Pikmin in extremely specific situations.
Okay.
Basically, those candy pop buttons. You remember the candy pop buttons, right?
Gross. No, I haven't seen those before.
That's about a Weevil. It's a bomb rock. Mm. It's basically a living creature that dies.
It looks like a spider.
Yes, they're four-legged beings. Four, they're called Weevils. And thing is, they carry stuff. Like, they carry your treasure, so you have to knock the treasure off them, and then you can attack them. And some of them exert electricity. So, remember, like, Pikmin 3, where you were using the... Pikmin 4 is not out. So, where you were using the electric gate, and there was not too much, and one of them got, like, stunned.
Yeah.
And I said, don't worry, the electric gate can't do anything.
Yeah.
Yeah, that is true. All it does is paralyze in this game. Paralyze in Pikmin 3. In this game, it's an instant death. Like, with water and fire, as you can see, I can pretty much whistle them. I barely lose any to water and fire because I can whistle them, and I usually don't lose too many to electricity because I'm really careful, but electricity, you have no chance. If a Pikmin that's not yellow touches it, that Pikmin is not alive. Oh, it was this one. Oh, of course it was the one with the Gatling Blade. Alright. What's the treasure meters? Alright, maybe I should pay more attention to the treasure meter.
What's the treasure here?
It's... Well, basically, you see that meter? That's gonna flash. And it's basically gonna tell you. Oh, yeah, so yes. In this one, there is... Oh, no. Well, Red died. I care so much about them. Alright, so... In this game... Oh. Amazing. I missed a treasure. No, purple! Pikmin are not the smartest. They thought I was swarming onto that bomb rock. Which, by the way, bomb rocks are... No, don't attack the volatile Dweeble. And I'm resetting, because I'm trying to talk to you at the same time.
Okay.
Alright, so... The treasure meter will beep. So, that's a power-up. So, like, you get, like, power-ups from getting stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And there is quite a lot of power-ups. Like... It was like 15 or something. So you have quite a... Wait, I can actually check, but... You have quite a lot of power-ups, so...
Okay.
You're pretty good. But... The whole point is... that with the... The point is, the thing about this one, this power, the power that allows me... The treasure gauge is the most useful power-up.
Mm-hmm.
Well, no. If you're not trying to complete the caves, then no, it's pretty useless, but... Alright, so yeah, that Gatling Groin, he's gonna move around. Gatling Groins! Basically, they shoot bombs. Yay. There is an easy and simple way to kill. Aw, man, you gotta be kidding me. That's not a gap wide enough. See, unlike Pikmin 3, oh. Okay, good. Now watch this. Going, going. Oh, no, no, no. Gotta make sure that he does this correctly. He'll fall off. Basically, I found out that in Pikmin 3, if items fall off, then they will respawn. Like, if an enemy falls off, it will just respawn with the same amount of health. But in this game, if it's a treasure or a dead body or something that your Pikmin can carry, it respawns. But if it's just an... Or if there's like a treasure in the enemy, that'll respawn, but not the enemy, if it was alive. So yes, think about Gatling Groins. Once you kill them, its health meter starts like regenerating, and if it gets back all the way back to green, it will come back to life.
Okay.
Same thing with ball bears. Same thing with ball bears, those, the ball bears, you know, the ball bears.
The black
eyes with the red spots.
Right.
In Pikmin 2, in this... 29?! What did I always have in Pikmin? Alright, so... The point is... The ball bears will regenerate too, like... Ball bears in this game are really bad.
Okay.
So yes, electricity is bad, ball bears are bad... And there are bumbling stitch bugs. And of course, who can ever forget the amazing... Whatever. I was gonna say. Oh, the Gatling Groins, they're bad.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. This is not an easy game. It's definitely a very long game. There are 201 treasures. And each 201... treasures, things that we need to collect. These treasures, the 201 of them.
Wow.
Fun fact. Probably gonna have to fight this guy. That was annoying, but probably oh yeah, purples. In this game are a lot stronger. They are actually good at fighting and have eight and do 3 times the damage on fighting this. Why did you activate the bomb rocks? Pikmin tend to activate bomb rocks. Alright, so here's how the purples work. They do 3 times the damage whenever hitting stuff. And that little pound they do, that in Pikmin 3 it's sort of for show. And sort of to show the weight. In this game that actually it actually stuns enemies.
Oh, okay.
Which means, number one, sometimes they stunning basically means they have these little dots up here.
Right.
Like you saw with the Gatling Groin. And it freezes in whatever position. Which leads to a lot of funny positions.
Yeah.
But that's not the point. So yeah, purples and whites. And whites. Whites are poisonous. If a Bulborb eats whites, it will hurt it. In Pikmin 3, if a regular Bulborb eats whites, it will kill like 1/3. Oh yeah, and by the way, Bulbears are stronger than Bulborbs.
Okay.
Not just the coming back to life thing.
Okay.
Okay, there's the Gatling Groin. We can probably kill him. Thank you.
getting a bit of a glitch, glitch, and then finally fall off. So, yeah, that's apparently a plant. Electric lights are now a plant. Yay. Alright, so, this sub-bubble is getting annoying. So, there are quite a lot of differences between Pikmin and Pikmin 2. So yeah, each of the 201 treasures, first off, 15 of them give you stuff, like, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 of them give you stuff.
Okay.
But those 12, like, right now I have, like, see how the cave's all white and stuff? That's not how it usually is.
Oh.
That was power up.
Oh, okay.
It takes away the atmosphere, but... Alright, good. None of them are gonna try it. None of them are gonna think I'm gonna You know what? I think that volatile Dweeble is just triggered to that treasure because every time I try to pick it up, it's killed Pikmin. Every time I try to pick it up, it's killed Pikmin.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, the treasure is leaping like crazy.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, So yeah, each of the 201 treasures have not only Olimar's has like a journal entry by Olimar.
Okay.
That's 201 things.
Wow.
And he talks about it. Thirst activator, twist to open, tree top, twist to open. But they also have a sales pitch written by the ship. That's 201 sales pitches and 201 journal entries. Plus,
okay.
They have Louie's journal entries in Pikmin 2, and Olimar's journal entries on the enemies in Picklepedia, or plants.
Okay.
Like, both of them. So, and like the candy pop buds, they don't have anything on the Pikmin, but they have stuff on the Bulbmen.
How many sub-levels are there?
This cave, in particular, has... Alright, so... I think I have... How many reds do I have? 2! Great, those 2 are reds. So... Oh, and they're both... No! So, yeah. Alright. What was I gonna... Alright. Oh, yeah, in these first two games. Oh, yeah, that's a queen candy pop bud. It spits out 9 for...
Oh.
I just realized... that I have very little. Okay, I just realized... The queen candy pop bud won't work. Oh, the queen candy pop bud won't work because you can't have more than 100 on the field.
Oh.
So yeah, you should be coming down here with. I don't know, what do you come down here?
You came down here in this one,
yeah.
93, right?
Well, yeah, you should be coming down here with... Oh, yes, I did find out that purple... Yes, that spot at 5, which is how much it spits out, but since one of them was a purple, it did not register, like... So, yes, if you throw... Candy pop, like if you throw purples into a formal candy pop bud, it's not the end of the world. So yes, we could go. I think we already have all the treasures, but I just want to show you this.
Okay.
And this is something I'm very disappointed. Like the enemy bosses and the Pikmin 3 are a lot bigger, creativer, 100% better. But some of these creative ideas, like they could have brought this back better. Like they did not have to like just completely scrap this idea. Because just look
Like, we are, as you can see, they're all sane. They would do that repeatedly if all the treasure was gone from the stage.
Oh.
But look at this. It's just, look, this is just beautiful. Look at this. This is the boss. I'm gonna refight it just for you.
Okay. Oh.
Meet the man at legs! And, like all enemies, it has a machine gun.
Oh.
This is like the Gatling droids blast, which I found out do not. Basically, you should watch my episode of me actually fighting this, because I have, like, a Pikmin, like, trapped on the outside of the barrier, and using the swarming command, I have him, like, do a bunch of dodging tricks, and he survives.
Wow.
I think it might have. Alright. Very important thing. Purple leaves. They're bad. They move slow. Flowers move faster than leaves. You know, like plants. Flowers, plants do not move faster than leaved plants. We know all plants are better. Like, flower plants are like the next stage. So as you can see, now it's time to do the trick shots. Oh, and I just realized I can do my other strategy. This is the strategist. It targets whatever's closest, so... Well, you should... So, what I actually do recommend doing... is bringing the capital with the most health... far away... Well, no, closer to it. Wait, so, what I suggest... No! Alright. It does pause, but you... No! That is not what you're supposed to do. Yes. Alright. So what I'm gonna do here is... I'm gonna hide you in this one. Wait. Okay. Come on, all we need to do is get out because that is... Oh, no, what? That's not what... It doesn't even attack so quickly. Like, so... Alright. What? Alright. This is... I think he got fed up with us for... But yeah, this is a really fun boss.
Mm-hmm.
It's not fun in challenge mode. We have to try to do it all with, like, with a ridiculous... We have to do it all with a time limit and, like, you're trying to get, like, absolutely no Pikmin dead. Then it's not that fun. What? No. See? There. That's what you wanted to do.
Oh.
There, I finally showed that strategy. Which is one that I have never used before, except in, like, challenge mode. I've never actually used in this story. All you gotta do is run away as far as possible. So yeah, instead of that big thing with your Pikmin being able to get trapped behind it, you're now gonna be, like, in this really open place. Overall, it's just... Aw, oh, man, you've gotta be kidding me. Alright, that's bad. Alright, now it's shooting at Pikmin that I was... I am not... Alright, so... I'll do another thing that I should probably only attack with the purples. Fight. Oh! Please don't fire. Please. Because this is how one of my captains died. Because this happened. I'm carrying all the precious purples with me. Okay. So yes, I tried this strategy actually on camera, and that's when Omar got like shot down. Alright, good. Okay, so I really need to lose a little bit. Because it fires at whatever's closest to it. Mm-hmm. Captain or Pikmin. And Louie has a lot of health, so I'm just gonna leave Louie behind there. Yeah, hopefully good. Yeah, now thing about, I do not openly suggest, like, I don't like Captain to use purples on this fight because he's just so annoying. Like, oh, that's not good. I do like how this is a really cool battle. I like how it is, but it can be very, very, very frustrating. Mm-hmm. Come on, kill it, kill it, kill it!
Yay.
Yeah, I killed it.
Good job.
So yes, if you... So yeah, basically, I killed a bunch of Pikmin and got nothing for it. Yay. I feel like I accomplished something today.
Yeah.
Like one treasure. And you talk.
Great.
So yeah. So yeah, and apparently none of the Pikmin drowned in that sequence.
That's good.
What else makes no sense? Oh yeah, the Pluckaphone. Thing is, the annoying thing about the Pluckaphone is, you get in a cave, and the cave, as you can see, most caves give you like 1,500 Pokos,
mm-hmm.
which is a lot, because that wind being was worth a lot, because 100 Pokos is more than a year's salary, apparently. But, ooh, we do have a profit on whites. Hopefully I can say the same on purples. Okay, it's not that good of a profit. We're supposed to have a slightly bigger profit than that, but okay. So, I will say that I do like the mana website. It's a... I'm disappointed that they don't have anything like it. Like, I mean, I know they only have three, and I guess it's going to Maestro, like, you don't know what I'm talking about. So, basically, the Pluckaphone, it's the Pluckaphone. You get it. In a cave, that doesn't give you much stuff from it, but it's one of the second most useful items in the game, and it saves a ton of time, especially with two looping stitch bugs, the ones that bury Pikmin in the ground. No more plucking, and then while you're plucking, it picks up this Pikmin, because you can throw instead of trying to re-pluck all the Pikmin, but eventually you're just gonna run out of Pikmin, and, well, you're gonna have a bad time. I actually did almost run into a situation like that on my first playthrough. No, the Pluckaphone, they decide it's very important. So what they do is they place it in a cave with very little treasure value because it only has like 16, 13.
Mm-hmm.
It's only 5 sub-levels long. So it's 5 sub-levels long, and that was like, what, 9 sub-levels long?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that was 9 sub-levels long. It wasn't very difficult. So yes, so this is a really big cave, and it's like 9 toes long, and you saw how it is, and that's a very frustrating cave.
Yeah.
The cave that we find the Pluckaphone in is called the Silver Castle. Oh. Probably I missed a treasure in here. Hopefully that's the only place I'm sure. Oh yeah, so this thing's called the Frontier Cavern. It's a cavern on the frontier.
Okay.
Alright, so what you want to do here is get just your whites, just your poison resistant people. And basically, if you throw directly on something like that's head, that's a doodle bug. I could have gotten a lot of, like, really good sprays from that, but... I guess it was just not to be that I would have something extra good. Oh wait, there's another one! So yes, white. You do not want to use... Alright! Like, look! Look at how much one white does to that.
Mm-hmm.
They are like... In this game, a white Pikmin... In this game, eating a white Pikmin is like eating 5 pounds of arsenic. You're gonna die. Like, ball bearers die under just 2 hits.
Mm-hmm.
As opposed to like 1/3 of their health being gone with just regular ball bearers. Plus they can see, plus they are not only the fastest,
mm-hmm.
but they can see underground.
Wow.
So like, there are treasures that are completely submerged, mm-hmm. and as you can see the little dig particles.
Yeah.
One of the life Pikmin is digging it up. So these are sprays, they give you like special powers.
Oh, okay.
The purple sprays is my personal favorite. So yeah, watch this.
Okay.
And you're supposed to pick it up.
Mm-hmm.
Thing is, that was quite a lot of work.
Yeah.
It will pick up if you get it by an inactive captain. So if the captain's not active,
mm-hmm.
it will pick up. And here's how it works. It will pick up. I mean, if it's in your party, it will pick up. But you cannot move or do anything during the... when your captain does it. So here's how it does. But, so you do the animation. And at the end of the and it's supposed to, and it gives you a spray for for the time it ends the animation.
Oh, okay.
So if you push the captain onto the spray...
Mm-hmm.
And if you push the captain onto the spray... Like, you push an idle captain onto a spray, and then you take a sip, you get 2 sprays.
Mm.
It's a glitch, it's not a very good glitch. It's a very good glitch. I remember back when I was, like, a kid, So they're doing all their, like... So there was this thing in, like... the grade, and they're like, alright, so do you think that having a cent per day, and then having it double every day for 30 days for something, do you think that would be a good deal? And I said, I was thinking multiplication power, that would be really, really, that would make a lot of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
That wouldn't be very fair. So I said, no, I got mixed up with fair and good.
Mm-hmm.
Because that is a great deal.
Yeah.
So yeah, this one that has no merit, but speeding through these one, like, I've already completed this game, but I slacked.
Oh.
So that's probably the only one I missed. Oh, that's a ball bear. That's a ball bear. Oh yeah, the kids, they will follow. Oh, and see, alright, so it takes out half the, so a white Pikmin takes out half the health of a bulb there in this game. Which, by the way, this is a very, so yeah, you see the health bar is red right now, and it's going up
once
that hits. Those are bulbmen. We have no use for them. They will roam around the stage, as well as the ball bear. The ball bear and the bulbman will roam around the stage. And you see those ball bear, like, the Bolt. And those are very, very, very fast. Mm. Pikmin. Bulbin, they are immune to everything. It's actually a parasite Pikmin taking over the Bulbor brain.
Okay.
So, yes. Bulbin, they can knock you out of caves. They are immune to everything. And, basically, yeah, that's it. Immune to everything. Yeah.
Okay.
And when you kill the mother, you get to whistle up the babies.
Oh,
which,
okay.
As you said, you have to eventually leave behind.
Right.
Such nice happiness.
Yeah.
Of the E-rated game. Wait, did I complete the cave? Did I finally complete all of... Yes, I completed the cave.
Woohoo!
No, wait, is there any more treasure? We are now going to... And now it is time for me to put away all my other Pikmin except for the yellows. And see if I can get this treasure that usually takes me an entire day to get. But you know what? I just like... I am the more slow and steady approacher.
Right.
So, except for battling, I usually am like chillaxed.
Okay.
We have exactly 100 yellow Pikmin.
Wow.
That's not good. We should have way more.
Oh.
I mean, like reds and blues. Reds we have like 126. In my other final reds, I have like 567. Like, you'll see, but... Because...
That's a lot.
Alright, now, where is that treasure? I know it's somewhere around here. What?
No longer.
Oh, no. So, we need to find... I'm hosting it. Alright, so, at the end of this day, I will go and show you what I meant to show you. So... Is it up here? This is just the Burrowing Snagger that's probably back. Alright, where is it? It's a brown bear statue, and I know what it looks like. And I know it's somewhere here. I'm not so familiar with these areas. And the caves are actually randomly generated, except for a very few.
Oh, okay.
I guess I'll sneak past this guy. Maybe it's past this guy? I'm gonna use him for an entirely new day. Oh yeah, here it is, right there. What we gotta do here is throw a Pikmin up there. And they will take it back.
Okay.
Usually this takes me forever to do because I just bring 20 of each type everywhere.
Oh yeah.
And as you can see, with the yellows, which can be thrown higher. So yeah, yellow is, fun fact, in Pikmin 3 too, so you might want to actually remember that.
Okay.
They can be thrown higher.
Okay.
As you can see, we only have like 13 on it. Pikmin, another big difference. Pikmin 3, the amount of Pikmin is on the top. In Pikmin 1 and 2, they have it on the bottom because that's where the Pikmin are.
Oh, okay.
So it's not out of, so it's no longer fractions, it's just comparing.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a ratio or whatever. So, yeah. Also, usually, what you do, you have to take out that fiery bulb wax.
Okay.
In order to get a treasure. I love to just use that guy, and I like take an entire day trying to aim that and get it exactly right where it kills the fiery bulb wax. Yes, it does actually work. Yes, I was hoping to show it on camera, but instead, because it's right there, and if I hurry, I can do the better strategy, the one that makes so much more sense, and actually get that treasure today.
Yeah.
So yeah, putting in all my yellows. And taking out all my blues because we got purple potions.
Okay.
That should be enough. Alright, so now, running! That's the yellows, they should be fine. I'm more worried about the blues. Come on! This is a really annoying thing, they're so slow. Basically, so yes, I will go and kill this the conventional way. How you're actually supposed to kill this guy. Even though it's the first time I've actually killed it like this, I always just kill him by, like, using that guy. Because it's fun. Anywho, if you want to be smart, then you would do this. Mm-hmm. Oh, this guy back.
Okay.
This bound bear. The majestic fossilized, whatever. All I know is that it's a bear. Oh wait, quick look. Oh wait, no, no! Also, I use it to take out the Wallywogs. Wallywogs are annoying, they can be bad. Don't let them kill all your Pikmin, blah blah blah. Throw on top, do not swarm like I usually do. I do believe that you can swarm if you have this big of numbers, but...
yeah.
Safe, better safe than sorry, you know what they say.
Yeah.
I think I said that in the wrong order. It's usually, you know what they say, better safe, and then better safe than sorry. Get back over here. This is the fiery ball blacks. Please note that it is a ball blacks and not a Borb or... Alright, so there, yeah, that is the whatever it's called.
Okay.
Probably something timepiece. Or stage. They like to think like things are stages. Like they call like. Like they think that like. And stage, like you're supposed to stand on it. Like they think that like everything's a stage. Like. I wonder what this like. Like, these all, like, resemble Earth objects, so, like, pad of, like, makeup pad, where they put on, like, the makeup stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I killed a Pikmin. Makeup! Makeup pad! Oh, that's a stage! You're supposed to dance on it! Yeah!
Oh.
So, I will you to go faster. Come on, Will, don't fail me now.
Down.
Will, I... Oh, wait, actually, do know. I know someone named William, but.
Oh.
Will, I believe in you. I'm gonna name one of you guys Will. Alright, take that back.
Where there's a will, there's a way.
Yeah. So, all we need is a guy named Will, and we'll be fine.
Yep. Well, if you named one of them Will, then you're good.
Am I gonna have to spend an entire day taking back. The very this is gonna land right in base, and I'm gonna have to spend an entire day. Well, that should be a that's just gonna be a huge day wasted. Today's report. Essence of Rage, Thirst Activator, Fossilized, Ursidare. Oh, yeah, Vista. Wait, these are really funny, the mail. Hello, I am still on the I am from...
Lamb.
On the Lamb from debt collectors. For the time being, I've decided to live under the bridge, but if they catch me, I don't know what they'll do to me. This is a really funny series,
yeah.
Because, like, I'll tell you, like, wait, I'll tell you after the recording session, because it's really
okay.
Funny. But, yeah. Alright, so, that will end this episode. Really long episode, and I will show at least a bunch of stuff that you can't see. Ha ha ha.